The SPCA says more education is needed to stop animal abuse in New Zealand. Now warning, you may find some elements in this story disturbing. The organisation's revealed the top 10 most shameful cases of animal cruelty for 2017, saying it's one of the worst the SPCA's ever compiled. Jenny Saw reports.
Come on, Max.
2-year-old Maggie has had to overcome some serious hurdles to get where she is now.
She's been wonderful. She's fitted right in once we've done the work with her.
Vaughan Kessel adopted her last year after the SPCA found her tied up with a metal chain embedded in her neck. Maggie's previous owner was sentenced to 160 hours community work and disqualified from owning any animals for 3 years.
Yeah, eye for an eye. If, you know, he should be wearing a chain for 6 months and have it growing into his neck just so he knows what it's like.
Maggie is one of 10 cases on the SPCA's list of shame, including a dog who was left untreated after suffering broken bones from a beating, and another who had to be put down after being hit on the head with a hammer. Some cases so bad, staff had to have counselling.
We have a real issue called compassion fatigue, so both the inspectors seeing those kind of situations, then they're coming back into the centre and the vets and the vet nurses having to deal with trying to rehabilitate.
The SPCA says this year's list is particularly shameful because so many of the cases involve not only neglect but senseless acts of violence.
Like Pippi, who had both her ears cut off. The person responsible has never been found. In 2010, the law was changed to allow harsher penalties for animal abusers. Despite this, last year the SPCA dealt with almost 15,000 welfare complaints.
It's about education. It's about people realising that animals are sentient beings. You know, they can feel everything that we feel, and we'd also like to see the judicial system deal with the mental health issues that we see coming through. So there's a lot of hoarding type situations, and sure, we can take the animals off them and deal with those, but what about the person?
That's it.
A message the SPCA hopes won't fall on deaf ears. Jenny Saw, One News.